Hi, this is Sean Matthew from Mainframe Hard Tutorials. In our previous video, I said to that we will do JavaScript validation in HTML forms. So to give a brief introduction of HTML forms, I am using PowerPoint slides. You can send suggestions for our next tutorial at seanmatthew.k@gmail.com. And in this video, we will do code in Visual Studio 2019. But you can do in any editor. But for JavaScript form validation, Visual Studio 2019 is the best selection. Because on other editors it might not work. HTML forms. HTML forms styling. We said about that in our previous video. And we use Bootstrap and CSS for HTML forms styling. Bootstrap is a responsive framework that is used to make a website more stylish and mobile friendly. In your mobile, you can take Google, Facebook, and many more websites. They all are responsive. They can be made with Bootstrap. But some of them are made with other languages such as Java, C Sharp, C++, and any more. So for HTML forms validation, we can use JavaScript. What is JavaScript? JavaScript is a server-side scripting language, which is also a language like Visual Basic, but has some more difference between it and this. So I will tell you the difference between some other languages which are similar to JavaScript. You can see that many of the programming languages are similar to JavaScript because they all are programming languages. But why is HTML not like that? We will discuss about it later. So now let's flip over to Visual Studio. And this is our file, which has many classes. And I have changed this path. And where is the Bootstrap file? It's in the lib slash means for the next path in that folder. And Twitter Bootstrap, we have a folder like that. And in that CSS, we have our bootstrap.css file. And you can see that it is opened here and it has a lot of code in it. Nearly 10,259 lines. But you have the minified version of that. You can see that there are only 7 lines in it. But you can see that it's with many bits. But it's same as this file. So let's close these files and now let's write code in it. And first let's click on the login button. Before that, let's include a form tag. Let's cut it. And now let's paste it here. I have this form tab because I am using the HTTPS verb and not either file or HTTP. So now I said input tag has a type attribute and button also has a type attribute, and in this we can set any one of these. Button type is equal to button is for a normal button, reset for is resetting in form tag, and submit is for submitting the data. And so let's write submit, and let's also include some more tags, I mean attributes. And this is a tag which is called required, and using that we can make the field required. That should be written 100% or it will show an error. So now let's save and build and run our project. So our build is succeeded. So now let's flip over to Chrome. So we are in Chrome now, and look, we have left the fields empty, and then let's click on login button, and you can see that there comes an information, please fill out this field. So let's fill out this field and let's write it in it admin, and let's again try to login. Then it shows the same message here, enter password, and let's include another password. And now let's click on login. Nothing happens because we haven't set an action. If we set the method to post and then put an action in it, then it will load the page that we want. So then you might have a doubt that from where does this message come? Have we set it earlier? Nope, actually we didn't set it. It's the specialty of this attribute. So if you click on the login button, then it will show and required this one required, but this will be not enough. If they click the login button, then we must make this login button disabled if they don't have any text filled in it. And for that let's include an ID element and let's set it to login, and how would we use this login? We will use it in our next video. And how to use it? We will use it using JavaScript. You can see that in our next video. ID is also something like class. It can be written in a CSS file, JavaScript file, and these two files only. And why do we include the ID attribute? It's mostly for JavaScript. JavaScript has a method called document, and the document has a method called document.getElementById, and it will get the element by ID, and that is why the ID is used. And we can also use it in CSS file by using hashtag. So thank you for watching.